President Duterte created Hotline 8888 as part of his administration's program for participatory governance. Most callers of Hotline 8888 complained of slow processing, unclear procedures, unattended phone lines, discourtesy, and failure to act on requests. The Social Security system topped the agencies with the most complaints so far this year. The CSC says such complaints are easily resolved since it's just a matter of following up or reminding agencies of certain procedures and deadlines. CNN Philippines went around several government agencies, and it seems many are pleased with the services except for some technical glitches.
Mabilis naman po ang PSA, yung servisyo nila.
Wala na yung mga picture na dating nakaabang sa labas, wala na.
Okay naman siya, kaso lang naabutan kami nung ano, sa offline, down ata yung system.
But some incidents warrant the filing of administrative cases at the CSC, from light offenses such as simple discourtesy to grave offenses including serious dishonesty. Such cases may be filed at the CSC, heads of agencies, and local government units. Administrative and criminal complaints may be lodged with the Ombudsman for filing formal charges at the Sandigan Bayan. The Office of the President also investigates corruption for presidential appointees. But critics of the administration point out, even while the government boasts of firing nearly 100 officials for allegations of corruptions, no cases have been filed.
Ang nangyayari ngayon, magsasalita lang, bravado, parang populist pronouncements, pero wala namang gawa sa aktwal. Hindi lamang paimbestigahan, kundi kasuhan, para na magkaroon ng accountability.
Anti-corruption NGO Transparency and Accountability Network, for its part, questions the lack of checks and balances with the appointment of many government officials perceived to be close to the president, even in constitutional bodies. CNN Philippines checked profiles of cabinet members and found that two-thirds have direct connections to Mr. Duterte. From Davao City, San Beda classmate or fraternity brother, and were with him in PDP Laban or during the campaign.
His first two appointments to the Supreme Court are people from San Beda. And he has 10 more to go, 10 more appointments to go. Dito natin makikita talaga kung may sincerity talaga si Pangulo dito sa fight against corruption.
The president himself assures he will not stop fighting corruption and even had to let go of members of his cabinet who are known to be close to him, amid what he says was a whiff of corruption.
Apparently, for the longest time, the people have become, in a sense, hopeless about the situation. But he is actually empowering the Filipino people once more by giving them a trustworthy government.
In 2016, the Philippines' standing in the Corruption Perception Index worsened to 101 from 95 in 2015. While the group Transparency International notes it was still too early to assess the Duterte administration's performance, it included the Philippines in its corruption watch list for 2017, noting the alleged presence of death squads and extrajudicial killings threatened democratic institutions in the country. Ruth Cabal, CNN Philippines.